Hello. Today I wanted to show you another tutorial on how to fold towels in a very decorative way to make your home look more luxurious, more retreat-like, and just have that comforting, welcoming touch to your bathrooms to comfort your guests, possibly. I missed you so much, so I couldn't stay away any longer. So I hope that some of you will enjoy this tutorial and possibly use these techniques in your own home. Today I'm going to show you three techniques, and we'll be using bath towels, hand towels, and I will use some ribbons for decorative touches. Okay, so let's start. All right. And we will be starting off by creating a roll cake type of a fold, and we will be using two-toned hand towels. You can use bath towels, whatever size of the roll you're trying to create is fine, and any colors combinations are fine as well. So today I would prefer to do a coffee cake with chocolate filling. And to start off, we're going to open up our little hand towel, and we're going to just stretch it just to lay it flat on the surface. Okay, and we're going to mark our middle, and we will be bringing each edge to the middle, like so. Fold, press, and smooth. And the same way on the other side. Fold, press, and smooth. Just smoothing the edges away. And we'll put that to the side. Yes, we'll do exactly the same thing with this brown chocolate colored towel. Once again, we're going to just straighten it out, just like that. Just. And again, we're going to find a middle, and we will fold, press, and smooth. Again, fold, press, and smooth. Now, chocolate is going to be our filling, so we'll put it on top of the lighter towel, leaving some edge out, just to not overlap each other too much, okay? And now we're going to roll it up. We'll just create little folds, roll, and we'll just keep rolling it, making sure that the towel does not come out too much at the edges, even though in real life cakes with cream coming out are the best kind, but not for these. So again, you can see two-toned towel. And then we'll just need to press it. Just think of it as if you are getting and you're kneading something. We just need to press on it. Put our weight right on top of it. Just so it stays and keeps the shape. Okay? Or we can use a little ribbon, any type of ribbon. We're going to just place it right in the middle, like so. And I will tie a knot. And make little bows. once again. You can keep it simple. You don't have to do the bows. Anything that you wish is just fine. Okay. All right. So something like that. Very cutesy. A little roll of towels. And I think that it will be so charming to have a few of these maybe in the basket somewhere, or just laying on the sink for the comfort of your guests. So I think that could be good. Now the next type of folds is actually something that needs to be hung from the rod, and I will show you everything step by step. First, we'll need to open up our towel, and we'll need to create the same type of a roll we just did with smaller towels. So let's smooth this one out as well. And again, we'll need to see our middle, which is right here, and we'll bring the edge right towards it. And stretch. And again, fold, remember? Breath. And stretch. And yet again, we'll start rolling it. This one doesn't have to be as neat, because as we'll show you later, this one actually goes in the middle of another towel, so it won't be as visual. So it's a little bit more forgiving this way. So this one you can just kind of have it whichever way, just a big roll. And I've also already created a smaller roll that will go over top of it. Okay. And to fold the towel that is going to hold all of the items in it, we just need to spread it out on the table, just like so. And I'm going to just smooth it out on the little edges. Just to try and have as little of these creases as possible. And once again, we're going to find the middle of this towel again. Grab the corners, bring them in, press, and smooth. One side at a time, or together. We're going to take another side, again, bring it in, and press, smooth, and again press, and smooth. So now we're going to just fold it in half. use a ribbon and I'll explain to you a little bit. When you do this fold, you place the rod, the towel over the rod in your bathroom in this manner, like this, like so, and then you simply tie the ribbon here at the bottom and then you flip it up. I'll show it to you in a second. So what we do is place the ribbon at this part here. Obvious spot for me to place it. Okay, so I'll do it like that. And now I'm gonna tie a knot. And as I tie it, it's going to get bunched up a little bit here. It's perfectly fine. Just don't do too much. But enough to create that strength right here. Okay, and I'm going to do little bunny ears. Carefully pulling out one at a time. And just stretching out. Okay. So I think that looks pretty nice. And again, imagine that you tie this on the rod and then you just simply bring it up like this on the rod. So this actually becomes a pouch. So the ribbon is going to hold the towel in place, make it look more organized, and at the same time this creates an opening right here. How wonderful. We're going to take our towels and place them right inside there, so it becomes perfect storage spot for all of your towels. Not all of them, but you know, combination. This way you can do a bath towel on the bottom, for example, the heaviest, and you can do a hand towel and a washcloth. You can also combine different colors to once again make a statement, just like so. You can use different colors, make different rolls. And this way it looks very neat, and I think it looks very wonderful. Just make sure that the knot right here is tight enough so that it will keep all of this weight over the rod, okay? So this is another fold that I wanted to show you. And now we're gonna come back and I'll show you a fold that is called a swan. You might have seen it in different hotels, but I decided to make it anyway for you and show you how it's actually done. So now onto the swan. Even though it's a little bit cheesy of a figure, I think it's still classic. It's still very nice. But it's also easy to do. So if you own a bed and breakfast of any type or expecting guests to arrive, you could do that as a gift for them. So maybe your one of your children got married and they want to bring their spouse or their girlfriend overnight, and you want to just give them a surprise. You can place that on their bed just to welcome them. For the phones, we'll need two big bath towels. You can make out of the hand towels as well, but I will do it out of the bath towels. Once again, first thing we do is smooth it out very carefully. These towels nice and clean, nice and fluffy. Okay, so we will need to split the towel in half. So this would be my middle, and what I will do is I will take this edge and I will just start rolling it towards that middle. We need to make sure and create a tight twist so that the neck of our swan is going to be gracefully bent. Okay. And as I do that, I'm just going to press here with my leg. And do the same thing on the other side. I will just start twisting it while holding the piece in the middle. It might start fighting you back, but don't worry. Just keep twisting. Just keep rolling. Just keep rolling. Like that. Okay. I'm gonna hold it all together. And just smooth out. Any of the folds that could possibly appear. Okay. Now we'll just need to grab this piece like this, flip it, and bend. And as we bend this, we're going to create a shape of a neck of the swan, like that. Okay, wonderful. I like to bend the ends inside because I'm going to make a skirt or a tail for him. So I'll put that to the side for now. And let me just put it here. Okay. We'll need a second towel. We'll need to open it up fully. And from the edge, we're gonna start doing an accordion fold. Be our tail in just a second. We're going to press on it in a second. Just to... make sure that it's going to keep its shape. So now and to fold it in half. It's going to be tricky to do, but doable. Okay. And we're going to bring our wonderful, beautiful swan. We're going to place this tail right behind his back. And we'll just spread his wings. Make him look festive, him or her, whichever way. You can always place a flower, a card, personalize it somehow. Maybe a candle or a candy. And make the room more welcoming. So, there is also another thing that you can do, but you don't have to. You can flip these spots. And this could create a certain ruffle. To his tail, to his wings. It's, of course, again, not necessary, but I think I could add something, help something. Just like that. Just dress him up a little bit. Make him look more fabulous, more dressy. Okay, so again, you can see that that has created a sort of a ruffle. I wouldn't recommend moving it too much. From all sides. So, at the first glance, you might think that it could be too much, but wouldn't you like someone to make that for you and surprise you with such a towel origami piece? They would know that you put your effort into it just for that person. That could make them feel very special, very loved. That could be very loved, very cared for. All these little details and attention could bring two of you closer, whatever that other person is for you. It's just cool to know these things so that you can show off to your relatives or to your friends. something that you can talk about. You can teach someone how to do this. Maybe play with your kids and create shapes out of towels. So, I hope you have enjoyed this. It was my pleasure. Thank you.